Welcome to Savita Dental College Lectica series in General Pathology. The topic of discussion is pathogenesis of tuberculosis. With a good immune power or immunocompetent host, the cell-mediated immunity will take place to get rid of the organism through delay type of hypersensitivity. In this delay type of hypersensitivity, we can get caseous necrosis with granuloma with the help of T helper cells. In the initial stage of primary tuberculosis, with less than 3 weeks of infection, the alveolar macrophages, which is present in the lung, will kill the organism, that is mycobacteria. When the bacillary proliferation is more, which is unchecked by the alveolar macrophages, it will enter into the bloodstream, causing bacteremia with seedling of multiple sites and cause clinical features like fever, cough, and hemoptysis. In the later stage, we can see the granuloma formation through interleukin 12, interferon gamma, that will activate the active macrophages and monocyte recruitment and cause caseous necrosis and granuloma. With the help of the T helper cells activation, tuberculin test will be positive, that is one of the investigation for tuberculosis infection. And this activated macrophages can kill the bacteria through free radicals. Coming to the investigations of the tuberculosis infection, first and foremost is a mantle test or tuberculin test, and second is the sputum acid phosphobacilli demonstration through special strains, and RT-PCR method, that is a genetic method, gold standard method for tuberculosis infection. The mantle test, we can see the injection, that is tuberculosis antigen, is injected into the subcutaneous tissue, and it will cause an induration that will be measured, and if it is more than 10 millimeter, the test is positive. In the sputum AFB demonstration through Zeal-Nielsen technique, we can see the bacilli in the background of methylene blue stain. That's all about the pathogenesis and investigations of tuberculosis. Thank you.